If you talk all the time, you'll never hear what anybody else has to say. And therefore, all you'll have to talk about is your own conversation. The same is true for people who think all the time. That means, when I use the word think, talking to yourself. Subvocal conversation, the constant chit-chat of symbols and images and talk and words inside your skull. Now, if you do that all the time, you'll find that you've nothing to think about except thinking. And just as you have to stop talking to hear what others have to say, you have to stop thinking to find out what life is about. And the moment you stop thinking, you come into immediate contact with what Korzybski called, so delightfully, the unspeakable world. Five colors, you're blind. And if you can only hear five tones in music, you're deaf. You see, if you force sound into five tones, you force color into five colors, you're blind and deaf. The world of color is infinite, as is the world of sound. And it is only through stopping, fixing conceptions on the world of color and sound that you really begin to hear it and see it. So, let me say again, I'm not talking about the ordering of ordinary everyday life in a reasonable and methodical way as being school teacherish. I'm saying, if you were nice people, that's what you would do. For heaven's sake, don't be nice people. But the thing is that unless you do have that basic framework of a certain kind of order and a certain kind of discipline, the force of liberation will blow the world to pieces. It's too strong a current for the wire. not what life is about. Chit-chat of symbols and images and talk and words inside your skull. Now, if you do that all the time, you'll find that you've nothing to think about except thinking. And just as you have to stop talking to hear what others have to say, you have to stop thinking to find out what life is about. And the moment you stop thinking, you become into immediate contact with what Korzybski called, so delightfully, the unspeakable world.